these questions. One of the common questions in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, and Egyptian board. We'll see our case now. This patient actually, the nurse from level 2 in ICU nursery calls you to evaluate baby. So nurse from level 2 in ICU call you to evaluate one baby. This baby is born 32 weeks gestation, is now almost 1 week old, and had been doing well on increasing NGT feeding, nasogastric feeding. Baby took it out. And afternoon, however, the nurse noted that the infant has vomited the last two feeding. Baby is preterm and he's in protocol feed. And today afternoon, the baby start to have vomiting twice. And seems to be less active. You see, the baby is less active. Less active. So this is preterm, 32 weeks. 1 week old, and afternoon the nurse noticed that the baby having vomiting twice and less active. So your examination, you came to assess the patient, and your examination at the time reveals what? Tense and distended abdomen. Tense, distended abdomen with decreased bowel sound. With decreased bowel sound. So your examination, the abdomen, it was tense, distended, and decreased bowel sound. As you are evaluating the child, he has also bloody stool. He has melena. He has bloody stool. So in summary, this is preterm, 32 weeks, 1 week old, is in protocol feeding. Today, the nurse noticed the baby having vomiting and also less active. Sure. So she is calling you to assess and evaluate the baby. Already you came and you examined the baby. Abdominal examination, tense, distended, and decreased bowel sound, and also there is melena or bloody stool. There is melena or bloody stool. This is the summary. What is your impression? This patient is preterm. This means having feeding intolerance. He's in protocol feed and start to have vomiting and abdominal distension. So this means this baby having feeding intolerance, or in general, it will be this is sepsis. This is late onset sepsis, but it's concentrated in the abdomen. All the problem with the abdomen feeding. So this is late onset sepsis, most probably feeding intolerance, to rule out what? Necrotizing enterocolitis, because this premature baby. So this is late onset. Your impression is late onset neonatal sepsis. And also feeding intolerance, to rule out what? To rule out necrotizing enterocolitis. Not necrotizing enterocolitis also. There is perforation or no, because there is melena now and the tense abdomen. So you have to rule this is necrotizing enterocolitis with perforation or without perforation. Sada ولا معها حاجة تاني. So your management of this infant should be included. A, surgical consultation for emergent exploratory laparotomy. You have to call the surgeon. Yes, you have to call the surgeon, but this is the stage to call the surgery, and if you will call the surgery, we'll do emergency exploratory laparotomy. We'll see first there is perforation or no perforation. If there is perforation, for sure, patient and the patient is stable, you have to go for exploratory laparotomy. So this is you have to notify the surgery. But you can notify the surgery, but for emergency exploratory laparotomy, you have to check there is perforation or no perforation. B, you have to continue the feeding of the infant, and this is gastroenteritis is usually self-limited. We are not in treating pediatric patient. This is preterm patient in NICU, level 2 NICU. So this is gastro is not matter of gastroenteritis. This is necrotizing enterocolitis, feeding intolerance to rule out necrotizing enterocolitis. C, I will send the stool culture to identify the etiology and the bloody diarrhea and infectious disease consultation. Again, we are not in the pediatric ward. We are in NICU. So because this is infectious diarrhea or bloody diarrhea, no, this patient preterm feeding intolerance, late onset sepsis, feeding intolerance, to rule out necrotizing enterocolitis, to rule out perforation, looking for the perforation. So it's not appropriate. D, I will stop the feed, begin intravenous fluid, and ordering serial abdominal fulmes and the initiation of the systemic antibiotic. This is the appropriate. This is the D. This is the appropriate. Patient preterm feeding intolerance, late onset neonatal sepsis, necrotizing enterocolitis. So what you are going to do? 5N. ان بي او ان جي تي فري درينج تو دي كومبريس ذا ابدومين جاست تو فنتليت ذا ستومك then normal saline you have to be liberal with the fluid you have notify the surgeon and non-specific non-surgical measures non-surgical measure like medical treatment you have to take septicor cup and you started antibiotic to start septicor cup so I have to keep this patient NPO NGT free drainage and fluids and notify surgery and septicor cup and start the antibiotics what about our GI series and barium enema to evaluate For obstruction, actually, is not the time. You have to wait for the pediatric surgery to assess the baby and the surgical team to assess if he's in need for upper GI or he's in need for barium enema, depending on the clinical condition of the patient. But put in your mind, preterm, and he was in full, he's in protocol feeding, and the sister or the nurse started to reported to you this patient having vomiting and this active, and you examine the baby having tense abdomen and distended and the blood stool. So put in your mind, this is late onset neonatal sepsis, feeding tolerance, rule out necrotizing colitis, and you have to rule out this perforation or no perforation because the management, it will depend on there is perforation or no perforation, there is emergency or no emergency, depend on the perforation or no perforation. So this is the answer. It will be stopping the feed, septicor cup, and start antibiotic medical treatment. Medical, this is now, we call it medical medical neck, medical, not surgical neck, until the pediatric surgery will come to evaluate, or you have to do the x-ray looking for the perforation, looking for perforation. This is x-ray. You see here, this is fixed dilated loops. If you see here, this is clinically the patient having abdominal distension. This is abdominal distension. And if you see here, this is x-ray, it will be, there is pneumatosis intestinalis. There is pneumatosis here, is pneumatosis intestinalis. It will make it bigger. This is the pneumatosis. You see, this is pneumatosis intestinalis. And here, this is a perforation. And here is a portal casus. In the ultrasound, you can see here the portal. If you see here the portal. Here the portal gases in the ultrasound. This is portal gases. This is the black dots. This is portal gases in the ultrasound. And this is exploration of necrotic tissues and gangrenous bowel. So this patient actually, if you see these patients, the infant is present in this question having necrotizing enterocolitis. And this is potentially life-threatening disease in the unit. We call it the GI medical emergency in unit. GI medical emergency in unit. Common in the premature babies as described in this question actually. And also the there is organism, several organisms can induce it, but in this case, actually no clear cause for this condition has been identified. And this patient having feeding intolerance and distended abdomen and melena, this is bloody stool. So pneumatosis intestinalis is found in the x-ray of the abdomen is diagnostic for necrotizing enterocolitis. Before it was pathognomic. But the pneumatosis intestinalis is pathognomic, but nowadays is there is other feature, there is other disease can induce pneumatosis in intestinalis. What is the management? Management depend on what? Depend on the initial on perforation. There is perforation or no perforation. There's no evidence of the perforation of the free air. Infant should put on what? Bowel rest by NGT decompression and systemic antibiotic are initiated. Electrolytes and vital signs should be monitored closely and serial abdominal film should be performed for what? To evaluate for perforation. To evaluate for, because there is perforation, this is emergency. It's called life-threatening. You have to call the pediatric surgeon, you have to call the surgical team for intervention. If the free air is identified in the x-ray or the infant is clinically is worsening with medical treatment, you have to consult the surgeon. So if the medical treatment is no benefit from the medical treatment or you did x-ray with the serial x-ray, you have to follow this patient within 48 hours for sign of perforations, you have to call the surgeon immediately. The surgery, it will depend on the clinical condition of the baby. The baby is less than 1 kilo and unstable, we will do just Bilrose drain. If the baby is more than 1 kilo and stable, he will do for laboratory or exploratory laboratomy. It's usually performed at any necrotic gut or gangrenous gut, it will remove. Occasionally, to remove the necrotic gut, it will result in the infant without any adequate intestinal surface area for absorption and nutrients, and this is called it can lead to short bowel syndrome. Short bowel syndrome after resection of the necrotic tissue or gangrenous tissue, maybe this baby having short bowel syndrome, having short bowel syndrome. What is the cause or the causes of the necrotizing enterocolitis? 3B, prematurity. This is the first one, the most important one. The second, it will be premature form in the formula feed. And the 3B of ischemic gut. Ischemic gut, perinatal asphyxia, and BDA, and polycythemia. Some medication may be indomethacin or steroid or combination. It lead to spontaneous perforation. Spontaneous perforation. There is call it old neck and the new neck. Actually, this is the term neck, ischemic neck, and the premature neck. It's call it is classic neck, and it's due to cow milk allergy association or transfusion association, or it will be due to lymphocytosis association disorders. 3B. This is the X-ray finding. The X-ray finding, it will be 3B. It will be nematosis intestinalis and also Porter gas and perforation. As Bell's criteria, the stage 1, it will be mild ileus, non-specific manifestations. Stage 2, it will be nematosis intestinalis. And stage 2A, it will be same stage 2 with systemic illness. And stage 3B, this is قولا واحدا, intestinal perforation. Necrotizing enterocolitis, any patient premature on the protocol feed, put in your mind, and start to have abdominal distension and feeding of tolerance, put in your mind, you have to, your impression to be late onset neonatal sepsis, feeding intolerance, necrotizing enterocolitis, to rule out perforation. This is will be your impression. Once you have patient like this, this is your impression. Immediately, late onset neonatal sepsis, baby is 1 week, and having abdominal symptoms. So this is feeding intolerance to rule out necrotizing enterocolitis. And if there is necrotizing enterocolitis, you have to rule out there is perforation or no perforation, because the management, it will depend on perforation or no perforation. I will treat medically or I will treat surgically. I will treat medically or I will treat surgically. Put in your mind, what is the causes? It will be 3B. It will be prematurity, the most important premature formula. This is the formula. And the 3B for ischemic gut, prenatal asphyxia, and BDA, and also polycythemia. And the X-ray finding, it will be 3B, pneumatosis intestinalis, and portal gases, and perforation. ومن أحياه فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا, سلام عليكم.